The Son of God reveals the Father. John chapter 1, verses 1 and 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. As we approach the Christmas week, of course, it is rightful for us to take time to just focus on the person of Jesus Christ. And this week, we want to focus specifically on Jesus as the Son of God. You know, what an interesting aspect of the incarnation. Here we have the eternal Word, the one who was with God, the one who was God. So the Bible talks about the triune God, the Father, the eternal Word, and the eternal Spirit, the triune God. And they are co-equal, and they are God. And the eternal Word comes as the incarnate human person that we know as Jesus Christ. And in the incarnation, he's referred to as the only begotten of the Father, the Son of God. And there is much that the New Testament has to refer or tell us and teach us about the Son of God. And this week, we want to consider a few aspects of the Son of God. God incarnate, walking as man, being referred to as the Son of God. You know, in the natural realm, when we refer to somebody and say, he is so-and-so's son, one of the things that immediately goes through our mind is, you know, if I see this person, I'm very likely to see some aspects of his father reflected in him. And so we say, you know, he's so-and-so's son. In a similar way, the Bible referring to Jesus, the incarnate Word, as the Son of God, points us to the fact that in the Son, the Father is revealed, or the Son reveals the Father. And of course, there are many references to this in Scripture. In that same chapter in John chapter 1, in the 18th verse, John says, no one has seen God at any time. The only begotten Son who is in the bosom of the Father, he has declared him. So he's saying no one's seen God at any time. But the Son, because he is the eternal Word who was always with the Father in eternity past, now that eternal Word has become man, incarnate man. So therefore he alone can declare or reveal or display or make known the Father. So the Son of God reveals the Father to us. He is, the Bible says, the exact image of the Father. In another place, Jesus said, you know, he who has seen me has seen the Father. So the Son of God reveals the Father. In Jesus, we see a true, exact representation of who the Father is. Jesus walked with love. He healed the people. He delivered the people. He met their needs. He spoke words of truth. He spoke peace into their lives. He calmed their storms. And this is exactly what the Father is like. This is who the Father is. He's revealed to us in the person of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. So if you and I want to know what the Father is like, zero in on Jesus. Focus on him. The Son of God reveals the Father to us. Let's pray. Lord, we ask that you help us recognize who the Father really is as we see him embodied and displayed in the Son of God, Jesus Christ. Help us to understand and get a true picture, an accurate picture of the Father through the Son. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.